So how will you define the reticulate venation? Is the venation which arises from the midrib or the main vein branch and then again branch to different degrees to form a reticulum. So when it forms a network or reticulum, it is called as reticulate venation. It is present in dicot except for these plants. So remember, it is present in some monocots, exceptions I have told you here. So these are dicots, but they do not carry reticulate venation. And these, because we know parallel is found in monocots, but these are monocots which do not carry parallel venation. I hope this point is clear to you. Based on the number of the veins, they are of pinnate type or the palmate type. Now let me quickly give you the example. So when convergent type is there, it is found in the case of Sisyphus. Sisyphus means bear. When we talk about this, even the grapevine or Vitis vinifera or the castor leaf, there are many plants of this shape. Even papaya leaf will appear to have this type of venation. But when we talk about people or Ficus religiosa or Ficus benjamina, in these plants we'll find this type of leaf is there. Very common, this one also. Now let's come to the next type. The next type is the parallel venation. So the parallel venation, veins arise from the midrib or the main vein and run parallel to each other towards the margin or towards the apex of the lamina. Veinlets are inconspicuous and reticulations are absent. It is present in monocots except in these two monocots. Because these two monocots have dicot venation and these are two dicots. So colophyllum and corymbium are two dicots which do not carry reticulate venation but carry the parallel venation. So it is present in monocot plants with some exception and present in some exceptional dicot plants. And based on the number of the veins, again it is of two type. It would be palmate type or the pinnate type. So if only one main vein is there and then branches, but remember branches do not go random. It's not a network. It only runs parallel. So when they run parallel, it is called as parallel type of venation. So how do you distinguish unicostate reticulate and unicostate parallel venation? That here there will be a network developing because the main vein divides into branches and branches go in different directions, different angles also. But in the case of the pinnate parallel venation, the branches will go only parallel to each other. And in the same manner, this is found in banana. If you see any banana leaf, this type of venation is there. Now when we talk about the palmate venation, palmate or multicostate parallel venation is again of two type, convergent and divergent. So remember, palmate will always have two types, convergent and divergent. Now this is found in grasses or you can say bamboo or the wheat plant, maize plant, rice plant, sugar cane, Saccharum officinarum. In all these plants you will find this type of venation is there. Now here what you find is similar arrangement. There is more than one main vein, so they are running in this manner, starting from one point and converging back at the tip of the leaf. But when you see the branches, here branches go in every direction to form a network. Here the branches run only parallel to each other. So they are running in a systematical manner. In this case, which is found in the case of palm, all palm or Ericaceae family, all palm belong to Ericaceae family. Now in this family you will find divergent multicostate parallel venation, because when you see the leaves you will find that there are finger type of leaves are present and they all start from one point and they go far from each other, so it is divergent. But the main veins, each leaf, each portion will carry one main vein, but from there only parallel arrangement of branches are there. So whenever you find parallel arrangement, consider it as the either multicostate type or the unicostate. And when it is carrying single main vein, it is unicostate. If it carries many main veins, it is called as the multicostate. If it runs from one point and converges at the other point, convergent. If it goes away from the center point, it is called as the divergent type of venation. I hope these points I have made clear to you. So now the next thing is, that Furcate tribe, just remember, is not found basically in the higher plants, but exceptional plants are there. It is very common in the case of the pteridophyta, but what you basically call as the ferns. Ferns fall into pteridophyta if you remember your 9th class syllabus. So I hope this much point is clear to you. So this brings us to another leaf. Now tell me, if this leaf is in front of you, you can easily see there is one main vein running in the center, and then branches are coming out from this main vein. So this is again a unicaust state, and you can see there are branches running in all angles, so it will be a reticulate type of unicaustate reticulate venation. When you see this leaf also, one main vein is there, and then branches are coming out from the vein, not from the tip, but from the vein. So this is also an example of maximum plant you will find with this category, unicaustate pinnate, or you can call it as the pinnate unicaustate reticulate venation. There is one more I have with me. Now this belongs to bamboo, so bamboo is a grass. So when you see this with the help of a hand lens, you will find there are so many veins running parallel like this, and they all meet at the tip. So they all meet at the tip, and then there are branchings running in this direction. So that's why this is an example of convergent type of multicaustate or palmate but parallel venation. So I hope you are able to make some distinction between all of these. Remember, these are the easiest topic, though this chapter is going to be the lengthiest one, but these are the easiest topics to cover. Now this brings us to the next topic, and that is the types of leaf. So leaves can be simple leaves or otherwise the compound leaf. Now when do you call a leaf a simple leaf?